ignorance if you know these songs. I want you to participate in the worship of tonight. This is to the glory of the King. And how many of you know he's coming soon? Come on, make some noise if you know he's coming soon.
Hi, my name is Pastor Clarence D. Roberts, and I would like to personally invite you to join me every Sunday, 5:30 p.m. Eastern, on www.sunlightradio.com for a Throne Room Worship Show. If you are looking to be inspired, if you are looking to worship the Lord, if you're looking for prayers, please join me each and every Sunday where we worship the Lord according to Psalm 34 in the beauty of His holiness. I look forward to having you. Come and let's have a divine encounter with the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, where we worship, we praise, we hear a word, and we pray, all in God's presence. May God meet you at the point of your need. Remember, this and every Sunday, 5:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, www.sunlightradio.com. We're looking forward to having you. God bless you. Well, good evening, everybody, wherever you are joining me from tonight. I want to welcome you to Throne Room Worship Show. Tonight is going to be another power-packed night. God bless you all joining from Facebook, YouTube. I see you, Sister Francisca, here already. God bless you tonight. We're just going to have a mighty time in God's presence. Please call a friend to call a friend to call another friend. Tonight is going to be another awesome time in God's presence. Please share on your timeline. We're going to listen to some music. And as we listen to some music, I want you to invite someone tonight. We have a great man of God in our midst will lead us in God's presence. It's going to be mighty tonight. It's going to be an awesome time tonight. I pray that God's divine presence and glory will be upon you. We are listening to Donnie McClurkin, Days of Elijah. Stay tuned. Don't change your dial. Share on your timeline. Share with a friend. Share with a loved one. It's going to be another mighty, mighty, I believe, mighty time. God bless you. Mrs. Rosemond Roberts, please let's share on our timeline. We're a little bit late today, but God is in control. We are going to go into His throne room. Stay tuned now. Don't you change your dial. Yeah.
bless you. I love you all. I'll see you. Oh, they tell me I forgot something. Ooh, sorry, Basala. I forgot. Ooh, Nintole.
Beloved, if you just join us, this is True Noon Worship Show. My name is Pastor Clarence Roberts. We are here every Sunday at 5:30. Please call a friend to call a friend to call another friend. We have a mighty time. Right now is Brother Soli. I love this song. Jesus is going ahead of us. Stay tuned. Wahamante.
I said, sing it for me. This is what they said. What's it?
God bless you. I love you.
house. Carter, you are here, my brother. Oh, God bless you, man. Thank you for coming.
I hope you are just rocking to this music. God is going ahead of you. My name is Pastor Clarence Roberts. I thank you to all that has joined us. Brother Robinson Brown, God bless you. Sister Vada Smash B, God bless you. Mrs. Francis Roberts, God bless you. Wherever you're joining from, Francisca, all the way from Ghana, God bless you. Thank you for joining us today on another day the Lord has made. We're going to have a mighty time in God's presence. Sister Quintina Stewart, I see you all the way watching me. God bless you on YouTube. God bless you. Now stay tuned. Please do me a favor, share on your timeline. Let's invite more people tonight. We're gonna have a glorious time in God's presence. We have a very special guest in our midst tonight, and he's going to take us into God's presence as usual, as we do here every Sunday 5:30. This is the day that the Lord has made. This is Throne Room Worship Show, where we enter God's throne room, where we lift our hands to have a divine encounter in the presence of the Lord. Please don't change your dial. Stay tuned. As we invite more people, I see more people coming on Facebook. Many of you listening on sunlightradio.com, listening via our mobile app on YouTube. We are so spread across now, so many ways. I can track all of you, but as many as I can see on Facebook, God bless you. Thank you for joining. On YouTube, God bless you. Thank you for joining. I see the numbers are increasing all over the place. Keep sharing. Invite as many as you can. We have a man of God from my home country tonight, from all the way Liberia, and he's here in the United States. Is going to take us into God's presence. Oh, glory to his name. Stay tuned. This is Sunlight Radio. Our theme for today is, Lord, I lift your name on high. Let's listen to Pastor Donnie McClurkin.
Lord, I lift your name on high.
Oh, yeah, you know it.
Sing, Lord, I love to sing your praise. Say, I'm so glad. Oh, my. Say it again, say, Lord.
I lift your name on high.
Lord, I love to sing, yeah.
I love to sing your praise.
So very glad you are.
So glad you live my life.
I'm so very glad you came.
Truly, he came from heaven to earth to show us the way. Wherever you are watching from tonight, if you're on YouTube, please just type your name, where you're from. We acknowledge you. I see Sister Quintana. There's many more of you on YouTube. Just type in. I see all of you. Reverend my Bishop Albert O'Crane, all the way from Chicago. Better House of Prayer. Sister Sarah Pine, God bless you. Thank you for joining. Share on your timeline. As many, I see many of you. Don't feel shy. Just type where you are listening from, where you are coming from tonight. We acknowledge you. The servant of God will be with us very shortly. We're going to just go into God's presence tonight, lift up our holy hands. presence and have a divine time in God's presence. So stay tuned tonight. As many of you are joining from wherever you are joining from tonight, I ask you, do not change your dial. God is going to lift up his hands over you. Sister Sarah Pine says she's watching from Facebook. Hallelujah. All the way from Alexandria, Virginia. God bless you. My goodness. My own CEO, Frederick Peel himself, is on YouTube watching. God bless you, brother. God be with you. God cover you. All the way from Pikesville, Maryland. That's Sister Quintina. My goodness, I think you get a prize tonight. Pikesville, I don't know who's further. Maybe a sister from Ghana. She's further, but in the U.S., you seem to be ahead of the crowd right now. All the way. Stay tuned. We want to listen to this song. Very soon we'll bring on the servant of the Lord. It is called "My Tomorrow Must Be Greater." You want to declare into your tomorrow that it will be greater. Stay tuned.
He cannot see your teeth. His ears are not deaf that he cannot hear you cry. Your tomorrow must be greater than today. Your tomorrow must be greater than today.
No matter what I face,
no matter
what I see,
no matter what
comes my way,
I pray that you stand to your feet and rejoice with me, and that your tomorrow will be greater. No matter what is coming your way, no matter what the enemy plans for you, your tomorrow, the Bible declares that God is going ahead of you to make every crooked path straight. You want to testify that your tomorrow will be greater. You are believing the God of heaven and earth, the God that said, "I will do exceedingly abundant, far above all you can ask or think," by Ephesians 3 and verse 20. I believe strongly in this God. Tonight we say we will lift up the name of the Lord wherever you are listening from. My cousin T. Hillary Roberts, Sister Equia, all the way from Canada. God bless you all. God bless you all. I'm seeing many of you log on. I prophesy over you that tomorrow it will be greater. It must be greater. God bless you so much for joining tonight. I see on YouTube here, Sister Mabel. I see Sister Siska. Oh my goodness. My God. I see Sam Nati. God bless you. Or your tomorrow will be greater. You need to prophesy and declare into that your tomorrow will be greater. Today it might not seem the way you want it to go, but there is still hope for tomorrow. The Bible says we walk by faith and not by sight. As you are walking by faith and not by sight, you are declaring into tomorrow that your tomorrow will be greater. When you get there, you will say the next day it shall be greater. Don't change your dial. This is Sunlight Radio. This is the Throne Room Worship Show. I pray we are building our audience. As we get to the point, we introduce the man of God tonight. Such a blessed brother. Stay tuned. Don't change your dial. This is Sunlight Radio. This is Throne Room Worship Show.
worship you. You are here.
We round it down now. We're taking it into God's presence. That God is a way maker. He has always been a way maker. He will continue to be a way maker. Bible says that he's the same God yesterday, today, and forevermore. Bring yourself and tune into the frequency. If you've been listening to me, you hear me talk about frequency. There are so many frequencies. You can tune in on the radio dial all the way from 89 all the way up to 99 somewhere. Depend on the frequency you tune into, you get the station or you get the flavor of music or news you're looking for. But when you tune into Throne Room Worship Show, your frequency is that of heaven. The slogan on Sunlight Radio here is we take you closer to heaven. I pray that right now you will tune into that frequency where you will hear the voice of Elohim, the one that made the heavens and the earth, the one that speaks over you, the one that is a miracle worker, the one that hands is not short, the one that is not a man, that he will lie to you. He cannot fail you. He will not fail you. Stay tuned as we get ready to bring on the seven of the Lord. He will lead us into God's presence. We hear a word and then we pray like we always do, because when you enter God's presence, the Bible says there is fullness of joy at his right hand. There are pleasures forevermore. Sister Amelia, Sintim, God bless you. Thank you for joining. Sister Mabel, thank you for joining. Stay tuned. We are listening to Sinash, Waymaker. The Lord is a Waymaker. He's making a way for you right now. May the Lord wipe away your tears tonight as you enter the throne room. May the Lord replace that ashes you are wearing. May he put on your robe of favor, that of glory tonight. You have tuned into Sunlight Radio. This is Throne Room Worship Show. My name is Pastor Clarence Roberts. I'm your regular host here every Sunday at 5:30. I pray that wherever situation you find yourself in, may the Lord make a way for you. The one that brought down the walls of Jericho when they thought it was impenetrable. I pray that whatever impenetrable wall be ahead of you, may the Lord bring it down. The Red Sea, a formidable foe, was before Israel. The Bible said they should go forward. And tonight I want to admonish you that no matter what you find yourself in, if God speaks, listen and do it. The Lord is speaking to you that he's a way maker. He's the one that will comfort you. David said, I lift up my eyes to the hills in the 121st Psalm. He said, where is my help coming from? He was desperate. He was looking for help. Tonight, are you lifting up your eyes onto the hills? Where are you looking for help? No hill can help you. Pastor Clarence can help you. No man can help you. David resolved in his heart. He purposed in his heart. He got a divine revelation. He says, my help is coming from the Lord, the God that made the heavens and the earth. When Paul wrote that, my God shall supply all your needs according to his divine riches in glory. I need you to watch this, child of God. I want to play this song. It's become one of my favorite songs over the past month. God is too faithful. David relied on the Lord when he faced Goliath. He said, listen, Goliath, you are coming against me with your spear and javelin. COVID-19, you are coming. Whatever they are saying, I'm coming against you in the name of the Most High God. God is way too faithful to fail you. I love this song from Moses Blaze. Stay tuned.
Yesterday, today, and forevermore, What you say is what you do. You never fail, you never change. You are faithful till the end. Faithful God, I worship you. I worship you. You're too faithful to fail me. You're too faithful to disappoint me. You've proven yourself in my life, and I've come to realize you're too faithful to fail. To fail me, oh Jesus, you're too faithful to disappoint me. You've proven yourself in my life, and I've come to realize you're too faithful to fail.
Oh, truly, truly, the Lord is too faithful. He will not disappoint you. Right about now, we want to just get into a time where we will bring on the servant of the Lord. We give you praise. We give you praise. We'll give you praise. We give you praise. We'll give you praise. We give you praise. My God, in the name of the Lord Jesus, we give you glory. Somebody worship the Lord. Somebody worship the Lord. Somebody worship the Lord. We thank you tonight. My God, in the name of the Lord Jesus, thou art worthy. Thou art worthy, O God. My God, we give you praise tonight. You have proven yourself over and over and over again. Ladies and gentlemen, wherever you are worshiping with me from, I pray that you listen tonight. We're going to have another mighty time in the presence of the Lord. Hallelujah. Pastor Moses, are you there? Can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you. Can you
How
hear
are you, man of God?
Oh, I'm doing great. How are you, sir?
I'm doing quite well. It's such a pleasure tonight to have you in Throne Room or on Throne Room Worship Show. We met several years ago at a good friend of mine. She was launching her album in New York, and you were just in God's presence, and we follow you over the years, and thank God for all that you're doing as you continue to bless the Lord. Tonight we have an interview with you, but we play some of your songs. One of your recent songs I know is just doing marvelous. I've downloaded some of your songs tonight. We're going to listen to them, but we will not let you go though. If you do a cappella, you will do a cappella together. We'll let you just bless the people of God. A people of God tonight, we have in our midst a son of Liberia, a good friend. He's laughing. Pastor Moses Soare, and I'm so blessed to have you here. We've opened this platform for so many to have a divine time in God's presence. I know you live in Minnesota right now, do you? Pastor Moses, can you hear me? I said you do live in Minnesota.
Yes, I do.
Yes, you do. Amen. So tonight we want to listen to one of your songs.
Yes, I live in Minnesota.
But it's too cold up there, though. Come to Virginia.
It's getting cold.
You know, yeah. I love recruiting people to Virginia because I'm in Virginia. So whenever you ready,
I'm always in the DMV area.
And there you go.
I'm always there.
We thank God for that, and thank God for your life and where God has brought you to. We will play some of your songs tonight, and by the time we get through with your songs, as the audience get into God's presence, we allow you to minister to us as the Lord leads you tonight. There's a song that you have. I love you. Did a live Facebook worship, and I downloaded it, and my goodness, it blessed my heart. So, ladies and gentlemen, please stay tuned tonight as we listen to this. From Pastor Moses Soare. Stay tuned.
Bible says for the weapon of the warfare are not carnal, but the power of Almighty God. Almighty God, Mantodiba, in you are everything my being. You are my rock, my hiding place. Oh, Lord, you my everything. Let's go again. Say, Almighty God. Almighty God. In you all living have my being. You are everything. Let's take it up again.
You are my all.
This is God's presence here. You're my everything, oh Lord.
Just worshiping in your presence, Lord.
Yeah. Just let that sink in. Let it
come
sink
on,
in.
Come on, that's
it. Yeah. Wherever you are, let it sink in. Listen. By the logo, which is the blood of Christ, when the enemies see that, they will pass over. I speak into the life of someone watching right now that
God is our everything.
Nothing shall do you any harm.
Thank you.
For you will come out. You will be victorious.
Yes.
The devil never succeeded then. He won't succeed now.
No.
Whatever you are going through, even if it's not the fear of this coronavirus, even if it's something else, know that our God is able to do all things.
Yes.
He's bigger than everything. Lord, you my everything.
My everything. Oh, hallelujah, Pastor Moses. That was such a wonderful time. People of God, I don't know if you just sense
Amen.
God's presence. Amen. God bless you. God bless you. God bless
Amen.
You. So tonight is going to be more interview, and then we'll listen and watch your videos you have. Right after this, we're going to go to Jehovah Overdue. My goodness. I don't know where you wrote this song from, but give us a people to get ready. He featured Eben on this. We're going to talk to him, Pastor Moses, for the next few minutes, and then we'll play this song. You get your dancing shoe ready. Wherever you are, stand to your feet. Pastor Moses, give us a background to this song before we go to
I was to work on an album that I'm working on now,
okay.
And that is going to be released sometime next year.
Okay.
So, and this album is more of a testimonial in the sense where it's a worship album, but more of a testimonial worship album in the sense where when I look back at, you know, two, three years ago and some of the lowest times of my life and how me just, you know, focusing on God and how he was able to take me through that. And so I decided to write songs that will reflect that.
Okay.
And this song, I decided to not write a worship song.
Mm-hmm.
For that, I decided to write a praise song this time around.
Amen.
So, and I said, you know what? Let me put a different flavor to it this time.
Yes, sir.
So I wrote the song. Jehovah Overdo Me is when something is done beyond your understanding.
Very good.
You know, it's not like Jehovah would just do it,
mm-hmm.
but he will do it. He'll overdo it to the extent
Ephesians
3:20, that you want.
It tells us that.
Yeah.
God is able to do exceedingly abundantly. God bless you.
Abundantly.
Yes.
Absolutely. So that's how I did the song. But when I did the song, I wasn't using it because I have a vault, you know, a library of a lot of songs I've done in the past, and mm-hmm. I even never got to release. So I did the song. The song was sitting, and Eben, my manager, and I were driving somewhere in the Maryland area, and then he was listening to a couple of songs from my past album, and then she played it for him. He listened to it. He loved it.
Mm.
And that's how we send it to the producer in Nigeria to redo the whole song.
Okay.
And Eben, you know, got on the song, and that's how we came up with that.
Amen. God bless you. Ladies and gentlemen, fasten your seatbelt. Don't change your dial. Listen to this wonderful
Get ready.
Music. Get ready, it's child of God, Jehovah Overdo.
It's Chai Keys on the beat.
Are y'all ready now? Give me the bamba, ha! Ah, na 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 na.
Testimony, you get a glory, Lord. Yeah, about you. testimony.
Testimony, testimony.
You got the glory.
Got the glory.
You got the honor and everything else.
You love me personally. You love me personally. You got the glory, Lord.
Papa, you are too good. God bless you. That summarizes and just put into context who God is and what he's doing for us in this day and age. What a collaboration with Eben and you. God bless you for bringing yourself to that point. I mean, I know the listening audience, all of you out there, please go out and get this song. Pastor Moses, where can we get this song?
The song is on YouTube, so
we're
keeping it on YouTube for people to watch it.
Okay.
And, you know, for people to keep watching the video and sharing it, because the song is going to be on the album that is coming up. So
the album
will be ready.
Yeah, I mean, it's that he loves me personally. That is a fact.
Yeah.
Bible says God loves you so much that he laid down his life for you. It was a personal thing that, I mean, he could lay down his life for you and I. Hallelujah. I pray that wherever you are tonight, that go find Pastor Moses Soiree on YouTube and I play this song over and over, that God loves you beyond the shadow of a doubt. You are the apple of his eyes. That's what the Bible calls you and I. We are so special to him, and thank you so much. We are lining up, but Pastor, like I said, you're not going to leave us. We need to hear you lead us into God's presence. If there's one or two songs, whether a cappella or however you want to do it, it is up to you tonight. But amen. Yes, but we're going to look. There's one other song you did on YouTube that an African worship and praise that you did. I want to play that as well tonight. And after that, we'll just let you lead us into God's presence. And as you lead us into God's presence, we pray that let his name will be glorified. We're still talking to you tonight. We'll find out some more details about who Pastor Moses is. Hallelujah. So right after this,
amen,
for the next few minutes, after we come back, we're going to speak to you a little bit more. Child of God, tonight, tune in. Worship is different. We just want to take you into God's presence. Stay tuned. And I remember you introduced a young man on this song as well, from Liberia, right? If I'm not mistaken, amen. So stay tuned. Listen, gentlemen.
Yes, Mr. Success.
Get ready for another time of worship with Pastor Moses Soiree.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage my friend and brother. You know, the man can sing in bassa so much. I'm like, Success, I can't do the bassa thing like you. So ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for Mr. Success Zing. You're worthy of our praise. Jesus. Hey, my quarter. You worthy of our praise, Jesus. Yeah, high five. Oh, me God, you worthy of our praise, Jesus. Oh, I'll take that one more time. Oh, you worthy of my praise. Oh, let the worship in this place, Jesus. Jesus,
the Lord is worthy.
You are You worthy of my praise, Jesus. You were my hiding place. Oh, my Lord. Just let it sink in for a moment.
Jesus is Lord.
Just keep it right there. Let it sink in for a moment.
Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. God bless you so much, brother. Wow. Well, ladies and gentlemen, you have been listening to Pastor Moses Wiry and me in here. We've been playing some of his music, and on Throne Room Worship Show, we cannot let him go like that. But before we get into him leading us into God's presence, lifting up his voice in this most holy place, Pastor Moses, I know where you are from, but you want to tell our audience, where are you originally from? I want to hail a special place, a special little place I know about. So Pastor Moses, where are you from?
I'm from Liberia.
Can you please say that again? You are from where?
I am a Liberian born gospel artist.
Amen.
Singer, pastor.
Amen.
Liberia.
Amen. Oh, to God be the glory. We thank God for your life.
Can you hear me?
Yes, it's kind of shaking a little bit, but we thank God that you are a child of Liberia, and I'm so very much proud.
Can you hear me?
Yeah, we can hear you, but it's kind of slow. So I will go to one of your music. Maybe we can fix the audio a little bit. Hallelujah. We thank God. He said he's a child of Liberia, and I'm a child also of that great country. I know I'm an adopted son of Africa, Sierra Leone, Ghana, but Liberia is my first home, so I cherish Liberia so much. We say God bless you for availing yourself. I want to play one of your other songs. Then when we come back, if your audio is okay, you wrote a song, God Alone. Hallelujah. Truly, he's God alone. There is none like unto him. We come to worship. We come to adore him. He's God alone. Stay tuned. Ladies and gentlemen, don't change your dial.
Right before you, You are God alone. Oh, you are God alone.
God bless you, Pastor Moses. So, as we say, we need to release you.
Grace of God.
To God be the glory. Amen. Go ahead, Pastor Moses. The airwaves is yours for the next few minutes. Hallelujah. Pastor Moses, are you there? We give God glory. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Please go ahead, Pastor Moses, if you can hear me. Thank you, Jesus. I believe we're still having some technical difficulties, but we want to thank God tonight for your life. Thank God for how he's using you to reach the world. And my prayer for you tonight is, as you continue to minister, may doors be open unto you. Amen. I think we're still having some audio problems, but we thank God. Like I said, we will have you on again as God continues to lift you up. Go ahead, man of God. Can you?
Amen.
Amen.
So I can hear you. I can hear you well. Okay. Just,
go ahead.
Okay. So this scripture I want to share with you very quickly before I take my leave, and it's acknowledge him and he will direct your path.
Amen.
Now, I just want to share this with somebody before I leave. Trust in so, you know, whoever. We are expecting certain things when we are not meeting the simple requirement.
Amen.
The Bible said, trust the Lord. People have to understand that faith actually works where you no longer have hope, where you've reached a breaking point and can no longer move forward. Faith cannot really actively work when you still have an understanding of what you want to do. Now, just because you have understanding doesn't mean that you have the wisdom to apply that which you understand.
Come on.
And the Bible says to trust in the Lord with all your heart. Lean not on your own understanding.
Yes, sir.
Most of us, we seek result, and whenever we try what we know and it doesn't work, and then we run back to God. Instead of using, we are using God literally as our substitute plan.
Come on.
And before I leave, I want to share this with somebody. Until you talk, he is God. Move in certain situations without envy. That means he's going to be breaking protocol. The protocol that is, the earth was given to men to subdue and have dominion over. Spirits cannot intervene on earth without man being used, without a physical man being used. So if you're in a situation, and I tell most ministers, most young ministers, that until you realize that you keep God, I don't know what to do. And I'm using my life example.
Come on now.
Until I got to a place that I told God that I have no option. I don't know what to do. You've given me the gift. I need instructions. Direct my path.
Direct my path.
The things I know haven't been working for me. I need you to show me a way. That's the only way certain things. That's the only way certain things can be able to work for you until you realize that your own understanding does not want to direct your path. You haven't put your understanding of who you think you are and what you're in the back seat. Still keeping God as your backup plan when you fail and then you run to Him. That's literally what you're doing. So I want to encourage somebody before I leave. I will take one acapella before I leave as we discuss.
Yes,
before
sir.
I leave, that trust in Him with trust. All your heart.
Yes, sir.
Lean not on your own understanding.
Mm.
And He, God, who is faithful and committed to seeing that you succeed, that you make it in life, will not and will never let you down and let you fall.
Amen.
So, man of God, I want to tell you thank you so much for hosting
me. I appreciate
me. I'm really grateful. It means a lot. It means a lot to me. I'm humbled to be, you know, to be on your platform today. Before I leave for the next 1 minute, somebody join me. Great is thy faithfulness, oh God, my Father. There is no
thank you, Jesus. Pastor Moses, we just want to thank God for your life.
Can you hear me?
Yes, sir, I can hear you. Thank you so much. We gave God praise. I want to go back to the first song you play, and I know you have another interview to do. As you get ready for that interview, God bless you for the grace upon your life, for making yourself available tonight. Child of God, we have just 13 minutes. I want to play again the first song we play in your live worship. After that, I'll pray with you and Throne Room Worship Show will be over for tonight, so please don't change your dial. I appreciate you so much for coming and making yourself available. I know we took you over your time. You have another interview to go to, but God bless you richly. I'll give you a call as soon as we're done. Have a blessed evening. Child of God, stay tuned. We'll play Pastor Moses again. This worship right after that will come and we'll pray with you tonight. Stay tuned.
The Bible says for the weapon of the warfare and a cannon. Almighty God, Almighty God, Manto de Bah, in you are led. My Yeah. Just let that sink in. Let it sink in. Wherever you are, let it sink in. Listen, by the logo, which is the blood of Christ, when the enemies see that, they will pass over. I'm speaking to the life of someone watching right now that no weapon, nothing shall do you any harm. For you will come out, you will be victorious. The devil never succeeded then, he won't succeed now. Whatever you are going through, even if it's not the fear of this coronavirus, even if it's something else, know that our God is able to do all things. He's bigger than everything. Lord, you my everything.
Oh, hallelujah. Indeed, God is our everything. Wherever you are worshiping me from tonight, I want to leave you with this. You heard Pastor Moses. God is indeed our everything. Tonight we choose as a team, Lord, we lift your name on high. When you lift the name of the Lord on high, you are waving it as a sign and as a banner. Many of us, if you a sports fan, as you watch the Olympics, the onset of the Olympics, when they do the grand opening ceremony, countries file past in the arena, and each country will have their name, someone carrying their flag, and you'll see America, you'll see Liberia. We had a Liberian on tonight. I am originally from Liberia. You see Norway, you see Ghana, you see so many countries. They identify themselves by their flag and the name they carry. And then you see, I am a Ghanaian, I am a Liberian, I am an American. When we lift up the name of the Lord, we are declaring that I am a child of God. God has marked me and I'm his. I'm a heir. I'm a joint heir with Christ. Once you become a child of God, the Bible says, if you confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus Christ, you will be saved. Once you are saved, we identify you. You are marked as a child of God. Tonight, before we close, I want to mention some names of God that I want you, when you walk throughout the rest of the year, lift it high, that the enemy will identify that as for this one, he is a child of the Most High God. I will not go near. Remember in Egypt, when God was about to deliver Israel out of Egypt, he said, do this, kill a lamb, an unblemished lamb, mark your doorpost. With God, there is always a demarcation. You are marked for success. You are marked for divine health. That is a covenant right you and I have. You can lift up the name Jehovah Rapha and it will identify that you, the Lord who is your healer, is going ahead of you. There is a name of the Lord called Elohim. He's the mighty creator. If you read Genesis 1 and verse 1, the Bible says, in the beginning, God created. You want to lift up that name. God, you are Elohim. As you walk, we are lifting up the name of the Lord. There are covenant names that God walks with, that God operates. Tonight, wherever you go, I pray that Elohim will go before you. The one that creates, may he create an environment of security around your life. May he create a wall that no hash, no pandemic can break through. There is another name of God. It's kind of peculiar. When you hear it, it might sound strange to you, but it's called Elkanah. Elkanah is the jealous God. You might ask me, why is God jealous? I don't know about you, if you are a husband or you are a wife. Each and every one of us exhibits some kind of jealousy. When you see somebody talking to your wife and you don't like it too much, you get some apprehension, something begin bubbling in your spirit. I don't care who you are. I've been a man of God. I've been married 24 years. I tell people, my wife, every time I see her, my stomach begin to bubble and begin to roll up because she's precious to me. You and I, we are precious. Bible says that we are the apple of his eyes. He cherished you so much that he laid down his life for you. So when you begin to go astray, when you begin to serve and worship other gods, despite what he has done for you, the Bible says he shows some holy jealousy towards you. At a point when Israel kept going back to other gods, he told Moses, and Moses, what is wrong with these people? What else do they want me to do for them? He says, I'm done. But Moses had to intercede. Elkanah, if you read Exodus chapter 20 verse 5, the Bible says, you shall not bow to them or worship them, for I, the Lord, Elkanah, your God, I am a jealous God. God cares for you so much. That's why he cannot just let things slide. When you begin to take your focus off him, you want to lift up your name, says, I belong to you, Lord. I know you are a jealous God. I love you. I cherish you. My heart and my desire is for you. There is another name of God from Daniel chapter 7 verse 9. It says, Atik Yomin. What does it mean? Ancient of days. He's not a God like any other God. There is no God to compare to him. Atik Yomin. Ancient of days. Daniel said, as I look, thrones were set in place. And the Ancient of Days, God is the Ancient of Days. As you walk through the rest of this week, he's not a God, he cannot lie, he's not dead, he's alive forevermore. Bible says that he's seated at the right hand of the Father after he came and laid down his life. He's the Ancient of Days, the one that was before time. Before we knew time, God was before time. Before we knew times and seasons, God was before that. Before we knew the sun, the earth, the moon, the stars. He's the Ancient of Days, none created him. Walk and knowing that God is Atik Yomin. He's the Ancient of Days. Tonight, I want you to lift up the name of the Lord. There is another name of the Lord I want to close with just for the next minute. It's 7 o'clock. It says, Hab Nefesh. What does that mean? The renewer of life. May the Lord renew your life in every age. In Ruth chapter 4, verse 15, the Bible says, he will renew your life and sustain you in your old age. For your daughter-in-law who loves you and who is better to you than 7 sons has given him birth. I pray for somebody tonight that may the Lord renew your strength, renew your life. No matter what is going on, as you lift up the name of the Lord, wherever you go, as you step into your car, call upon the covenant name. You are El Shaddai, you are Makadesh, Jehovah Nissi, the Lord who's my banner. Mention and carry God's name, the covenant name, that when you mention, there are certain names that I know from my wife and my wife knows from me because we've been intimate for many years. There are certain look I gave her, a certain look she gives me, we will immediately understand. When you begin to mention God's covenant name, it invokes something for you tonight. You want to call out the Hab Nefesh, the Lord who's the renewer of life. Say, Lord, I'm hearing so many things. Many are dying, almost 200,000 people, but I'm exempted because Hab Nefesh, the one that renews my life, he is with me. The time is 1 minute past the hour of 7 o'clock. I want to bless you tonight. That may the Lord bless you. May the Lord keep you. May the Lord make his face to shine upon you. May the Lord lift up his countenance unto you and grant you peace. Child of God, go confident in the word that as you lift up God's name, we cannot take it for play. Which side are you on? God has his eye on you. May the Lord bless you tonight. May the Lord lift up his countenance. Grant you divine peace. You are blessed. I call you blessed. You are the apple of his eyes, because that is true. God is watching over you. I cover you with divine protection, the one that comes from heaven that no enemy can penetrate. Your children, as they go to school, I cover them with the protection of Jehovah. May the angels stand guard and watch over them. When David said, he that dwelleth in the secret place, may you dwell and abide in the secret place of our God, in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus. Bless you now. Join me next week, 5:30 p.m. here on Sunlight Radio, True Noon Worship Show. We're going to have another powerful time in God's presence. Please don't change your dial. I want to play you this final song tonight from Kwesi Oteng. Hallelujah. God bless you. Shalom.
Mercy and kindness, great are you, Lord God. Great are you, Lord, who is faithful and mighty to save. Great are you, Lord, full of glory and splendor. Great are you, Lord God. Great are you, Lord, who hear when we call on your name. Our God's worthy to be praised. Our God's worthy to be praised.
My name is Pastor Clarence D. Roberts, and I would like to personally invite you to join me every Sunday, 5:30 p.m. Eastern, on www.sunlightradio.com for Throne Room Worship Show. If you are looking to be inspired, if you are looking to worship the Lord, if you're looking for prayers, please join me each and every Sunday where we worship the Lord according to Psalm 34 in the beauty of His holiness. I look forward to having you. Come. And let's have a divine encounter with the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, where we worship, we praise, we hear a word, and we pray, all in God's presence. May God meet you at the point of your need. Remember, this and every Sunday, 5:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time,
www.sunlightradio.com. We're looking forward to having you. God bless you.